No one listens to anyone anymore. We can easily repeat something several times to someone just to find out everything we said was not heard or understood. The waiter doesn't recall the extra dish we ordered. The cashier charged us for an item we requested removed. The bank teller gave us 20s after we had said we wanted hundreds. And the driver made a right when we clearly said, make a left. These and hundreds of other examples are frequently found in our lives on a daily basis. We seem to be increasingly having difficulties with listening and paying attention. Why is this the case? Is it because everything around us wants to grab our attention, interrupting us and distracting us wherever we go and wherever we are? So we end up tunneling everything and anything out. Nowadays, we live in a world under constant siege from commercials, billboards, pop-ups, and celebrity pictures, advertising to us and trying to sell us and convince us on something we often don't need or really want. Maybe this is why a lot of us have become very impatient in our daily lives, wanting to avoid all the noise, the interference, and chaos. We now want everything done quickly, briefly, and faster. But decreasing our willingness and patience to give someone enough time to express themselves fully when we're talking, it's something very different. When we lose consciousness and awareness of our surroundings and environment, we stop listening. Listening is one of the main ways we interpret and experience the passing of time. When we only hear what someone is saying, we do not remember much of what was said a moment later. Our brains will constantly be trying then to write the script of what it wants to hear and say next. And in the process, it will get so busy coming up with a crafty response to something we notice in our conversations that we lose track of time and we detach ourselves from the moment, spacing out. This is where imbalances and points of omission while we're conversing are very common. It is part of the reason why we say things that don't make any sense and frequently unrelatable to the flow and timing of a topic in a conversation. If in a conversation we act and respond in accordance to what we already believe in, filling in the gaps with our bias opinions and preferences, we come across as egoistic and egocentric in our behavior from our unwillingness to assimilate and comprehend another person's points of views, thoughts, and opinions. And this bad habit, it can have long-lasting negative effects on our social and personal interactions. Listening is a skill we learn from an early stage in our lives that needs to be constantly exercised and practiced. Hearing is something we do to differentiate important and relative information from what we consider ordinary sound or noise. We are supposed to be listening when we're talking to someone and to search for the meanings of their spoken words and their underlying needs, wants, and emotions. We use language to communicate our values, beliefs, attitudes, expectations, and intentions. We incorporate signs, movements, facial expressions, tone, melody, and common sounds to convey information while seeking understanding and our desire to be understood. Conversations are about doing our best at getting to understand and learn from another person. We are to set aside our beliefs and opinions and actively listen to everyone we encounter. When we learn more about people by actively listening, we are more likely to find areas of compromise and to reach mutually agreeable and satisfactory solutions to any disagreements, conflicts, and misunderstandings. When we only hear someone's words and react without understanding, we get to experience more presumptions and assumptions and confronting situations, negotiations, arguments, and opposing encounters that can commonly last longer than needed. Why? Because while one party is talking, the other one is only hearing, but neither one is listening. When we attentively listen, we learn how to read, relate, and communicate better with people. We get to prevent and anticipate negative issues before they arise, and we get to act instead of reacting to life's events, opportunities, challenges, and situations. By being present and consciously listening to others as much as possible, we detach expectations from our conversations, and we experience more enjoyment, contentment, and peace from our social and personal interactions. We get to connect with people and have more confident, coherent, engaged, and inspired memories and occasions. Everyone we meet has something to teach us. All we need to do is listen. Not with the intent to reply, but with the intent to learn and understand. We all need to be heard and be understood, and to feel a connection with our fellow man and surroundings. Active listening. It is the golden key to having open and thoughtful relationships with our loved ones, family members, and friendships. Take a look at our videos that complement this message. Share, like, and subscribe. Become a patron by clicking on the link below, and we will see you back again on our next video. Cheers!